tell you what, that was pretty impressive. I'm going to hire Martin and just take him with me everywhere I go, like before I go in the restaurant or before I stop and do gas or walk out and do anything. I have one important housekeeping item. When Scotty Elliott asks you to do something, you certainly do it. So here you go, Scotty. Prove it. Right there. Whoever you promise that to, we always follow through on our promises. How are you all doing so far? Good deal. That's pretty good, considering we're almost done, and a whole bunch of salespeople have been in here listening and sitting instead of walking and talking almost all day, so I'm very impressed. There's one thing I want to do. You've all been taking pictures all day, but I'm going to get a picture of all of you, and there's a reason for this. That's right. Yeah, smile, wave, look good, look big, right? And I had to do this because this room is so wide and full. I don't exist without all of you. And I don't have anything to wake up for or do without all of you. Okay, so I want you to know that's the most important thing to me, and I'll share more of that with you. Now, Martin was kind enough to say he got to the coveted seven figures. I've done this for 29 years. I got into this business because I decided after 5 years of active duty in the Navy, I saw the world. I almost saved money to go back to college. I didn't figure out what I wanted to do. I was sure at 19 I'd know when I got out. I didn't. But I knew I needed a job, and I knew it was time to go somewhere else. I was called to move on. I couldn't tell you where, but I just knew I had to go. And so someone walked up to me and said, "What are you going to do?" I said, "I don't know, commercial real estate, someday maybe law school. I've got dreams." He said, "Do you ever think about selling life insurance?" I'm like, "No." He goes, "Check out what I made last week." And he made in 1 week what I made working 18 hours a day as an E5 and volunteering for a short bombardment team, hazard duty pay, you name it. I did it because I didn't want to be bored at sea, right? In about 1 week, he made what I made in about 1 month. So I looked back at him and said, "Actually, life insurance? Well, I've been thinking a lot about getting into that business." I did not have a plan to make $1 million a year. I love it. People are like, "Hey, become a millionaire." My question would be, then what? Like, make $1 million and quit? Or amass $1 million? What does that make you? What does that mean? And what if it happens really soon? You just lay down and cover yourself with dirt and say, "Well, I guess I've done all there is to do." How about make $1 million a year every single year? I want you to write, before I show you, the builder program. We call it recruiting, but the truth is it's building, and the secret is it's duplicating yourself. So remember those three things. But here's what I want you to write down. We're going to do math. The number 75 times 2,500. 52 times 0.10 times 0.10. You'll really mess it up if you put times 10. It's times 10%. Okay? Remind me at the end, and I'll tell you what all that meant if you haven't already figured it out. Okay, so I want to touch on something else. Here we talk about where we come from. I want to give you a snapshot of a part of my childhood. We lived in about a 1,000-square-foot home. It's not a rags-to-riches story because I've been rich since the time I was born. I just didn't know any different. So wherever we were, whatever fun we had, we had. If that's all you know and you still have fun, then what's it matter? You've got it all at any point in your life. You just have to see it. And so for us, here's a quick snapshot of one of the homes we lived in, about an 1,100-square-foot house, two bedrooms, one bathroom in the middle, small kitchen, one living room. Across the street was a house about the same size. There were at least six people living there. They all rode motorcycles. And at night, when it got cold, towards the end before we moved, they were peeling off side parts of the house and using it to keep their fire going outside. Nicest people, among the nicest people I've ever been around or met in my life. Because they were there, they protected, that was the neighborhood, that was the way it went. Again, I did not sit there and go, "Boy, this is miserable, I gotta go make a fortune." My plan is to make a fortune. I didn't have a plan. I mean, I had a plan, but I was guided the whole way. A lot of you are in this business, you don't know why, you got into it like I did. What I will tell you is right here, right now, you're here. Everything prior to that is knowledge you can glean from and either use or not. But you're here because you're supposed to be. what you do with it is the cool part. That's the exciting part, because only you control that. So, I believe everybody wants to get to six figures. I did. How many of you show that? Be honest. And please participate. You're already answering yes. Thank you. The first thing out of your mouth when someone said, what's your income goal? I want to get to six figures a year. Show of hands, who said that? All right, so show of hands, who said a different number? All right, what was yours? Seven figures. I love it. You're going to get there with us. That's not a problem. How do I know? Because I already like you better than I like me, and you're sharper than I am, and certainly than I was, and I got there. Where you get it will be a byproduct of the system you plug into, the conviction you have regarding it, and your passion for others. That's where you'll get it. Who you're with matters, because they're giving you what you're using to build your future. They're helping you shape your foundation. That's massive, folks. It does matter. So let me help you out with one real important thing as well. I am not here right now for this next 2 hours. I am not here to motivate you. I think we've done a pretty good job of that earlier today. I really do. So I'm not here to motivate you. In fact, I need you to motivate me. That's how this is going to work. So as I go through this PowerPoint, you are going to help me. You'll be rewarded, because you'll remember, and you'll put it to use. But also, I'm going to give out some things just for fun, even though they didn't say I could. I will. When you get to seven figures a year, you got that right. How to do it anyway, right? So I really want to help you with this. I'm not here to motivate you. We've had plenty of that today. So I do want to recap a couple things. We've had some amazing speakers, and they put a lot of stuff up there today. And I look at it, I don't know about you all, but I'll just use what you get with me. I look at it, and I look at all these things they've done, and all their lists for stuff, and all the, I mean, it's so awesome. And I look at that stuff, and I'm like, there's no way I can do all that. There is not a speaker that's been up here today that has put their formula up here that I've said, yep, I can do all that, and I'm already doing some of it, and I'm going to start doing the rest tomorrow. I don't know about you all. I can't do all that. But here's what I know. I know I can do some of it. I guarantee you I can do some of it. It means I have to try and embrace the parts I know I can do, and at least understand the other ones and figure out where my jump-off point is. Because if I can even be half to three-quarters of what those folks are doing and embrace that, wow. So think about that, because it was impressive to me. And I want to recap a couple. Just in case you all didn't take notes or lost them, I want to share with you some of the things I was impressed by today, if you don't mind. Okay? So, Richard Reyes, the script. I'm going to come at that again and again. I'm going to use that in future training, the script. Denzel and Russell, would you ever believe they read from a script? Would your prospect ever believe you did? Think about it. How about the Roses? What did I take from them? I took trust. They questioned, and then they looked at who they were partnered up with, who they're embracing, who's helping them build their brand, and whose brand they're uplifting as well. Trust, right? And they became fearless through that. It's okay. It's okay, because if the culture's there, and if the real is there, everyone worthwhile will always be here, and everyone seeking forever will eventually show up here. I'm not going anywhere. We'll be bigger. Jordan Kemper, how about stop the selfies and point the camera the other way? To me, that resonated hard. AKA, focus on others. I don't care what I make from any of this. I only care what you make from picking apart everything you can from what I've done. I have been where you've been. I have been where you're at. I've been where you're going. I've been where you think you're going. I've been where you're trying to go. And I actually accidentally went further. And somehow I was blessed with this epiphany to put it all together and put it in an easy-to-learn manner for you all to do as well. Now, you don't have to. You can look at it and go, well, you know, that building thing and that producing thing and that identity thing. I mean, it's okay, but I got some good stuff, too. Yeah, I take no offense to that. I only made 7 figures a year repetitive. So your stuff's probably a lot better. Don't worry about it. Feel free to just use yours. Or question mine. I don't know about that. Yeah, me neither. It probably doesn't work. Probably outdated. Probably no good anymore. Right? So I take no offense to that. It's okay. Now, Eric, integrity. I saw great integrity. Who you win with is important. You're all winners. You're all fearless. Hey, you're independent contractors like commission only income. I mean, you guys are nuts. Just like me. And nobody's ever going to be able to make as much working for someone else as we all can make working for us and embracing family and culture. Thank you. I have your payment in the car. I appreciate that. You come in with perfect. No, thank you. You're motivating and that's a good class. That's awesome. You know, Jordan too, simplicity. You know, those three basic things. I really wake up 1 hour earlier a day. That's such a huge one because we can all do that. And it's what you do with that hour. If I toss and turn and try to go back to sleep, well, that's no good. But what we do with that hour, have a plan with that hour, I love that, right? You know, Ricky with identity. When people speak, I think jump right off the page at me. Identity. We talk, if you learn MP or FP, whatever you do, don't sell insurance. Talk about what it does. It starts with your identity. Holy cow, that's the cornerstone for every dollar I ever made and getting to all the dollars that I did get from helping others, starting with families as a producer and going to helping people because I'm so excited about what was out there that I never knew existed. I want to share it with the world. I still do. I try and figure out in a short 45 minutes how to get 29 years out of my head and into yours because I know if you know, you're going to go do it. And that's all I want to see is you do. And I just can't wait. And so it's hard sometimes to have to get on the wheel. It's hard to stay focused, so I do my best. And I promise not to go too far over my back side. So how about Mary? If you're the person always at the top of your circle, if you make the most in your circle, start finding other circles. People can take that the wrong way. Don't. You're not abandoning the people you're with. You just need to aspire to see if you're at your max or if perhaps your bar could be raised. Because none of us can raise our bar alone. And if we do, it's so brief we can't sustain it. And this is about forever, how long that is for all of you. And so by embracing others that you look up to, the next thing you know, you're with them. And I guarantee you, you're helping them raise their bar and you're building culture. Mary, that was fantastic. Jim Sweeney, there's a reason. And it's you. I mean, that's an awesome dude. He was totally transparent, you know, and really organized. And the whole wine and discuss the bills thing. Angelo, yeah, I don't think we're going to do that anytime soon because you'd be mad at me. I spoke too much, especially on shoes. And here's another thing. Hey, what can I say? I love Lee Mowry, and I'm trying to follow him as fast as a fashion cat. So, Brandy Clay, I want to know, honestly, from all of you, with a big shout, yes, for those of you that had a connection to Brandon before he sent us for lunch. Did anyone else notice commonalities amongst all those speakers? So, like 10 of you. That's good. The commonalities are off the charts. To me, it was incredible. And the commonalities were all over the place. If you listen closely to these speakers, the core message you tend to hear is the same thing again and again. And with all due respect, Williams Primerica. 29 years ago, the very first policy I delivered as a 24-year-old agent, there was a Primerica agent and a district manager in there with a video camera trying to just intimidate the heck out of me. But I embraced the training system I was taught. I believed in what I was doing. I stood my ground, turned the whole thing around. It's hilarious. I'll share the story with you sometime. You know, I'm going to go one step further than that man and his great success. Yes, you need to do it. But what if we give you a proven track from someone who's already done it and give you all that you need to do it and don't charge you for it and then tell you to do it? What's your excuse then? Because at that point, you've got to look in the mirror. See, that's the scary thing. Careful what you ask for. You just might get it. Trust me. If I was making 80 grand a year and I went to $1 million a year tomorrow, I'd be a train wreck. I'd blow it all. I wouldn't know how to handle it. It's too scary. But if you get rich slowly, if you do it on a foundation, if you don't even realize it when it happens and your accountant points it out to you and you're like, yeah, okay, whatever. You know, it's a byproduct of what I'm doing. I'm more interested in doing this because there's more people to help. There's more fun to have. There's more things to do. It's about that, not that. And that never goes away. And then you go, I haven't even scratched the surface. It could be $10 million. It could be $30 million. It doesn't matter what it is. It'll be a byproduct of the system, your commitment to it, and what you do energy-wise with it. That's a fact in our business, and that's why I have it no other way. So, let's get into building and recruiting and all that cool stuff. So here's where you all are going to help me out. I'm already tired of my own Mississippi. All right. Let me jump off to here. Sorry, Dan, I can't see that far back to that TV. Anyway, all right, so, boom. Why are you, I told you you were going to motivate me. Why, how many of you actually, let me ask you first, by show of hands, do any of you want to have downlines? Who, by show of hands, does not ever want to have a downline? Good. I was going to let you go, because that's what I'm going to talk about for the remaining 20 or 30 minutes. So, since you all want it, then we're going to talk about it. So, help me understand. You want it. Why? Ever play the game Family Feud where a couple people come up and they ask a question and you beat the thing and say the answer? So, let's have a little fun. Let's do a little Family Feud. Why do you want to recruit? Say it again. Mailbox money. Is that what you said, mailbox money? What's that? Money that someone else is making for you, okay? Not a bad answer at all. In fact, you were the first one to shout it out, so you get this awesome gift, right? Now, if you want, I'll put it in your mailbox. It's not full of money, but I can start you on that path, right? Mailbox money, what else? Shout it out. To duplicate yourself. What makes you worth duplicating, man? No, really. I mean, that's an honest question. We have to know. I couldn't agree with you more, right? I couldn't agree with you more. Duplicate yourself. But you have to understand, when you build, you're going to duplicate yourself. So is that a good thing or a bad thing? And if it's about making as much as you can, helping people and helping them get as much as they can in spite of themselves, is that a good thing, right? So, very good answer. Very good answer. Yes. You're just plugging the name of your company. Financial freedom is exactly right. Who's heard of the old passive income, right? Passive income. You lay on a beach and you just get money, right? And everybody takes your distribution because they get mad at you for laying on a beach and making money. I want you guys to realize if you make an override, you are employed by that producer. Start there and let everything else evolve from that. You ever think of it that way? It is financial freedom because you can't make. You could probably, like Spencer can make $300,000, $350,000 a year by embracing the system and evolving and doing all those things as a personal producer, which means lots of other people can too. But you cannot make $650,000 a year. That's for all you that said, oh, but I can get half a million. Good, I can get that. $650,000 a year, $850,000 a year, $1 million a year, right? I believe if your goal is to try and make $1 million a year, you might never get there. But if your goal is to turn people on to what you know to be true, to do the best you can in the system you're in, to know as much as you can about it, and to say, do as I say, and who said it? All right, hold on, I got something for you too. And as I do, nothing sounds lamer than do it that bad, girl. Help me out. I'm not doing that. Thank you. Give her a big hand. She don't got to come up and get a hand. Do As I, nothing sounds lamer than do as I say, not as I do. Really? Why do you get a pass and I don't? Right? We're going to emulate the behavior, whether you think back. If you tell me that, I'll probably just copy you, and then I'll be gone for you. So do as I say and as I do. Such a huge deal. Right? You're going to go something. Help change people's lives. All right, so let's go with the three answers. How are we doing? Number one, you want out of the field. Mailbox money. Mailbox money. Right? That's not the number one answer, but it is the most common answer we get. And it's a slippery slope for all of you. I said this morning, briefly, I'm not going to sugarcoat it. If it was easy, everyone would do it. It's possible, and it's the easiest thing you'll ever do. The hardest part is getting it to where it's the easiest thing you've ever done. If it was easy, everyone would do it. What you get with us is real. When we celebrate, it's real. When we love, it's real. When we talk to you, it's real. What does that mean? It means if you plug into me and you truly want to know it all and get there, you're not always going to like everything I tell you. But 30 minutes later, when you cool off, you're going to go, you know what? I really hate him now because he was right. And you know what? I actually love him because he believed in me enough and he respected me enough to be honest with me. Too many people in our business today out there are trying to tell you what you want to hear because they're trying to stick you on the wall with everyone else they're throwing against it. We are not going to tell you what you want to hear. We're going to tell you the truth. We're going to tell you what's right. And we're going to help you. If you're trying to build because you want to get out of the field, it's a dangerous place to start from. What have I seen agents do for decades? They become really good in the field. They come to us making 30, 40 grand a year, working, I don't know, 40 hours, 50 hours a week. And then they make 80 grand working 25 hours a week. And they're like, you know what I want to do now that I'm great in the field? I've doubled my income. I want to get out. So I'll go find a bunch of people, just have them do this too. Now I don't have to do it anymore because it's pretty easy for me. I'm sure everybody I plug in will be pretty easy for them too, right? That's the slippery slope and the dangerous part. If producing is a numbers game and your customer is the consumer, then what is recruiting? It's still a numbers game, but your customer becomes the, yes, the agent, the producer, exactly. I can't have out any more bags, but that was a great answer from all of the trouble. So you want out of the field. Hey, it's a good motivation. It's a good reason. Evolve to that. Through turning others on to how great life became when you went in. Number two, you want to make more money. Yes, it's okay to want to make more money. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to recruit. I'm going to pour all my time into it. I'm going to prioritize it right there with my faith and my family and my hobbies and everything else. But here's the deal. I want to get paid for it. I'm going to do it all for free. Let's be honest. We love what we do, but we wouldn't do it for free. And it's okay to be honest. Yes, I'm doing it to see my income grow. Number three is to, if you want to get really wealthy and have it be meaningful and sustain it for a long time, do it for number three more than any. Let the first couple be motivational reasons to get you on the path. But understand number three, you'll have sustainability. You want to turn people on to the most amazing career and income opportunity you've ever seen. If you don't believe that, then how in the world are they supposed to? Until you embrace it as the most amazing career income opportunity you've ever seen, I can talk to you about that. I can plug you into this, and I can be relentless in my conviction that if you do it, it's life-changing. It only gets better. It never goes away. We deal with our core markets as homeowners and seniors. They're not going anywhere. Long after we're gone, there'll be others that'll step in and take care of the ones that succeed them as well. This never goes away. You are at the doorstep of forever, career-wise and financial-wise, and infinity as far as income-wise, if you care about other people. But how can you pitch the opportunity of a lifetime if you don't believe it first? Don't fake it till you make it. Go out and make it happen and sing it from the mountaintops. And watch the people you attract law of attraction, Maxwell. All right, I got some rules and guidelines for you. Luckily, I've done this, and I did it for quite a while, and I made a lot of mistakes. I learned a lot of things, and so I decided that there should be some basic rules and guidelines, and so here they are. One of the first ones, don't go broke trying to get rich. Mailbox Mike. All right, I'm going to start. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to spend all my time building the team. I'm going to stop recruiting. You know what else? I'm going to stop producing. Do you know what the words are? You know what I just described for all of you? Two words right there. I'm going to stop producing because I'm going to build the team. Call reluctance. It shows up in many forms today. It'll wreck you. Don't let it. You got to look at it and laugh. That's an excuse for you to stop prospecting and stop producing. You can do both. This business lets you do both. So don't go broke trying to get rich. You guys good with me there? All right. Number two, you have to treat this like a second full-time job. Let me tell you a little bit about this job. It's going to suck for the first couple of years. It is. It's going to be pretty thankless. There'll be small victories. Here's the good news for all of you. I've been there. You can vent to me. Don't vent to them. You don't even want to bet at home, because you're not going to be home as much if you do this right. It is a second full-time job that for the first 2 years probably won't pay you much of anything. You can't quit your day job. Here's how it normally goes. I'm going to start building the team, so I'm going to stop producing. So when you talk to people, let's run through these just briefly. Hey, Mike, what do you do? Oh, well, I'm self-employed. I'm my own boss. I set my own hours. I get to coach the kids' sports. I never miss a game. I make unlimited income. And I go on at least one free lavish trip every year. And I'm at these celebratory meetings that are pretty cool, too. Who's going to say, wow, that sucks? I'm so glad I got my job punching a clock every day and being forced to work 50 hours and only get paid for 40. Isn't it true that everybody's going to be like, wow, I want to do what you do? Right now, folks, everybody wants to do what you do. They all want to be you. You understand that? It's very important to understand. Everyone you talk to about what we do is going to want to be you. And here's the thing. In the moment, they probably believe they'll be you. But there's some fundamental DNA that dooms a lot of these folks to failure. For example, how cool would it be if I could come back, Martin said all those things, and that's what he does. I'm like, I'm out of that job. I'm in with you, right? So here I go. Wouldn't it be cool if before I did that, I could come back to you and say, hey, Martin, I know I was excited, but I want you to know if I've got to be a false starter, like, if you're not going to come kick me out of bed every day and make me there somewhere, I'm going to fail. Don't waste any time on me. Seriously, how cool would that be? Right? Or, Martin, if I have to reach out to total strangers, it's not going to go with me. I'm not your guy. Don't waste any time on me. Martin, if there's rejection, like if people actually say no to me, or I don't want to see you, or they hang up a phone on me, not going to work for me. I'm going to freak out. Right? Wouldn't it be great to know? They don't know either. So on Wednesday, I'm going to show you a complete system online, walk you through it from 9 to 1, and it's going to address how to identify all that without wasting any of your time. Without wasting any of your time, right? So let's see if I can do it. All right. So you have to treat it like a second full-time job. Because you see, again, as you wrap up that thought, what do? We produce great. And Jeff Holmes, he's like, wow, I was really scared when you decided to be a commission-only income earner because you quit your job, make it 50 grand a year, and we lost our benefits, and so that's not scary. But you said it'd be okay, and we'd break through if we got out of working for someone else and worked for ourselves. And, you know, it's so wonderful because we just got back from Aruba, and everybody's so nice there, and it was free, and they liked us, and we made $88,000 this year. I'm like, yeah, honey, but it gets better. I'm going to stop doing all that and go find a bunch of people to do it for me and show them what I've learned, and we're going to make $880,000 a year. But don't do that. Here's why. Because in and amongst going and doing that, I stopped doing what made me $88,000 a year because I stopped producing to build. And so what happens at home when I stop bringing the income in? It freaks out. And then I'm frustrated at the people because they don't do it like I did it, so I'm not making that mailbox money. And now I wasn't producing, and now I stopped producing, and starting from a stop is brutal. So now I got to start all over again and produce. I feel like I'm taking a step backwards. If I stopped, and I shouldn't have stopped. And I try to bring all these other people in, and she's freaking out at home, and I'm freaking out in the field. And we wonder why we wash out of the business. You can have your cake and eat it too. I'm going to push you hard to accomplish that. Push you hard to accomplish that. Second full-time job. Nobody gets in the way of your personal production. And while you're building, if you're building with people close enough to you, have them come on appointments with you once they've learned the presentation. Value your time. I'll cover more of that on Wednesday. But that's huge. Make them earn it. Because you're only going to find the good ones. Second full-time job does not pay you anything for the first 2 years. Come into it with your eyes open. Because if you stick with it, after 2 years, it will be the most lucrative thing you've ever done. And if you do it right with a system and culture and people that care and for the right reasons, it actually begins to take on a life of its own. How do I know? It wasn't my master plan. I didn't know any of this until it happened. I'm just sharing with you how I got to where I got to, because I know it's where you're trying to get to. Three, identify your target. Are you going after licensed people or unlicensed people? There's a difference. What's great about licensed people? What's good about them? They already passed the test. Hey, it's heat meat, right? I mean, they're already cooked. All you got to do is just, the dinner's ready. How attractive is that, right? And how attractive is all their baggage? All right. Unlicensed agents. What's difficult about that? It takes a while. You got to do more. But you do get more margin if you build that way initially, and then you ramp them up as they become less dependent on you, and you get them, you duplicate yourself through that process, and they'll do it too. But you should, if you can do a combination of both. On Wednesday, you'll see how, well, it sounds like a plug for Wednesday, it's not, but it is. So, on Wednesday, you're going to see how to go after each one, how to sort them, and how to really not have to deal with them and only find the good ones. All right. Take every opportunity to leverage all the resources available from your IMO. Too often today, points are the only thing people look at. That is such a painful mistake. You're in partnership with us. I work for you. That's not lip service. Those who know me will vouch for that. I work for you. I don't see it any other way. You allow me the income I have, the freedoms I have. I want more. And the way to get more is to work harder for you so that you get more. That's how it works. That's why it works. And that's why it's forever. So, utilize all the resources. What are they? Figure them out. Ask us. Use us. Use me, please. You got a budget? It costs money to recruit. It costs money. Figure it out. You got a budget, time to recruit. It costs time. That's the second full-time job thing. Production time is sacred. I got to have my week set up. I'm going on my appointments. I'll build around that. Nobody's worth compromising my home life, my success, and my validation of path I'm on and how real it is. See, once you're great at personally producing, no one can ever take that away from you. Ever. Never. You can always do that. Sure, and you can always get a little better. So don't compromise that. So we talked about money. How do you do that? Okay. Rules and guidelines. You've got to identify your recruiting methods. In other words, what's your pitch, gang? You're going to recruit me. You're going to recruit me. Just because I'm not a candidate for you. But you're going to recruit people, so what's your pitch? Direct mail, that's how you're going to reach out to them, right? Are you going to go over the internet, Facebook for recruiting? Emails, ringless voicemail, ringless text, teleleads. We back up. these are some of the ways that you can recruit in targeted areas to show your value proposition to your prospects. Drew Gurley's going to be in Wednesday. He's phenomenal. He's with Redbird. He's great at this stuff. He's going to share with you some stuff I can't even comprehend, but what I do know is it attracts the right people, and we want to talk to the right people, and it maximizes time and efficiency. It costs money. Gee, what a wild idea. All right, know your message. Sorry, I got a little ahead of myself. I was excited to go over this one with you because it's my favorite. What are you recruiting me to? What is your value proposition? Have you thought about that? See, everybody wants to build. Have you put this much thought into all this stuff, right? No, I just want to get a bunch of people to do what I do and make some money. It doesn't work that way. So are you pitching the opportunity? How about more leads? By show of hands, would your value proposition be, I can get you more leads than where you're at right now? Is that a value proposition? Is that appealing to people? You guys are supposed to motivate me, so yes, right? Better leads. Man, I want to get, if I can only get good leads, how about if we make you great and get you the best quality lead in the fastest time possible? Why are we motivated to do that? Because we don't make money until you make money. More calm. Culture. Carriers. Products. Live and total support. Out of all those, by show of hands, which one appeals to all of you most? You all have to participate on this with me, all right? Opportunity by show of hands. Is that the most appealing thing if someone's recruiting you by show of hands? Couple of people, okay? I want to know the opportunity, right? Is it limitless? Is it already saturated? What is it? What am I doing? More leads. It's just by show of hands. Okay, good. Better leads. Yeah, okay. I'm glad too many guys didn't go up there. They already get leads from us. That's good. But we're always trying to make them better. More calm, right? Pretty much, there's great comfort. So, culture. Culture matters, folks. They'll leave you for what they came to you for if you're recruiting licensed agents, okay? So, if you bring them to culture, nobody matches our culture. The more you're with us, the more you'll see that. I don't have to sell that. That stuff sells itself. It starts with that guy. Snotty and quickly down to everybody that touches that guy. No doubt about it. He never has to talk about himself because all I hear other people talk about is him. That speaks to culture. That's what I want to bring people to because I know they'll stick. Carriers. Carriers matter. If we have carriers and proprietary products that others don't, that gives you a competitive edge. So we strive to do that. And internal support. Thank you. That's a guy who actually has been with other organizations, thank you, Mitch, and plugged into us and has taken the time to embrace it all. And so I agree. You know, the bottom line is this. I think all the above are important to recruit to, but too much rope you can hang yourself. So when you go to advertising, you identify your target market and you formulate your message, pick your favorite from all these once you've experienced them with the organization you're bringing them to. Because if you're bringing them to you, you're bringing them to us. We're going to love on them as much as you love on them because we want them to be greater than anywhere else. That's how we all win. It's the only way we win. Identify the good ones. You want to figure out as quick as possible who's worthy, and you want to lift them up with you. That's who you want to spend your time with because time is money, and nobody's time is more important than yours. And eliminate the bad ones. They will waste your time. Just take me in the field and write some more business and put it in my name. Just one more night and I'll know, right? Or you're chasing them. Don't do that. So, don't have unrealistic expectations. That's why I gave you that formula earlier. Johnny put that together. So, big hand for Johnny. Thank you for that awesome, awesome slide. Get rich slowly. You have to have realistic expectations. It is one agent at a time if you're building directly to you. It really is. So work the numbers. You ever hear sales work the numbers? What are you doing when you're recruiting? It's just a different form of selling. That's all it is. The more you prospect, the more you'll sell. The more you see, the more you write. Same with this. All right? So get rich slowly. All right. So let's come back to this. Actually, let's get off there. So in closing, I want to share one short thing with you. I want all of you to reach whatever financial breakthrough you want to reach. Because I can sit here and tell you, having done it beyond anything I've ever dreamt, that I dream pretty big. But this business is so lucrative. If you do it for the right reasons, it's so incredible. Because earlier, one of the speakers said, if you think it's money, it's not. And I can tell you this, every one of you that hasn't hit that financial mountaintop yet, that doesn't resonate with you. You can't figure out that it was never about the money until you make the money. That's why I'm so passionate about you getting there as quickly as possible. Because let me tell you the painful thing that is going to happen to you when you hit that financial pinnacle. The people who don't like you aren't going to start liking you. They're not. And the people who love you aren't going to stop loving you. They're not gonna love you anymore. And the ones that don't like you aren't going to not like you any less. And there's a sadness associated with that because you thought it was everything and all the answers, and you realize it wasn't. But here's where the breakthrough happens. You realize it's about what's next. And behind that door lies your real life purpose and your real passion. And a lot of you don't know what that is yet. So for some of you, being a personal producer forever, making $90,000 a year, is it. That's your financial pinnacle. And at that moment, you'll realize what really matters to you in life, what your true passion is, what really makes you feel good. For me, it's working with heroes, wounded combat veterans. And I never would have known that had I not reached the financial pinnacles and had the painful realization I had and had the what's next and been driven to the next thing I was supposed to do in life. And so my true why do I do this? Why do I still do this? My number one why is you all. Because I want you to, someday, some of you, I wish all of you, we all have different callings, but a good number of you, if you stay with it and embrace and make this your all in, you'll look back and go, now I know what he was talking about. He was right. I am. I've been there. My why is for all of you to have the ride you're looking for. And it's never going to be a better opportunity for you than here and now and with me and with us. That is a fact. An absolute fact. And no one's going to truly care more about you and your success and demand you impact others and focus on them first as you begin to build than me. Because without that, it doesn't happen, and it'll never happen to the level it should for you, and it won't sustain itself. And then, when you hit that financial pinnacle, I'll be there to talk to you, and I want to be there when you figure out what your true why is. My why is you because it allows me to do what my real why is. My real why today is working with combat wounded veterans, and I want a good, dear friend of mine, Patrick, to come up here for a minute, if you would, Patrick. United States Marine, wounded in combat, so that we can argue with each other. Together a year ago, year and a half ago. Some of you remember Patrick. He was here with David Boris, adaptive training, and David's doing a great job. But we were down in Texas on Operation Red River, and Ange flew in, and they have a big event, the band, Lone Star, one of those bands play. And he's a way better dancer than me, so him and Ange danced all night. I'm not a very good dancer, so that's not really good. You are a good dancer.
this is my why, this is what we do. And I'll tell you, last week in Southern Ohio at Operation Cherry Bend, he and I and jumped off a plane together. We were strapped to a person with a parachute, so it's all good. But I will tell you, we uplift each other. And, you know, I love my wife. I love this guy. I love everybody I get to work with and spend time with. We're friends. We're family. And I tell you, I don't like heights. I don't really like airplanes. And I certainly don't like jumping out of them. But when this guy says, you're going, right? I'm like, oh, I got to do dishes and help clean up for the event tonight. And you're really wrestling over something. And he grabs me and goes, seriously, I'm going to jump. And just jump in. You go. You know, and I will tell you, the best is yet to come. But to be able to jump out of a plane with a man who gives me my freedoms and is a hero for our country and for everybody else, and to have friendship and fellowship, folks, that's why you got to commit. That's why you get to that financial pinnacle, and you break through from there. I want you to go to Operation Cherry Bend. I want you to Google it. I want you to friend it on Facebook. And I want you guys to stay involved. You don't have to go find your passion now. It'll come to you. Go find your next. If it's 100 grand, go get it. And then your next door, and your next door. But when you hit that pinnacle, you'll find your passion. And that's what this business gives you. So, also a special thank you, Richard and Raina. I know they're in some meetings right now, but they've gotten heavily involved in Donate as well. It's not a pitch to donate. The whole purpose of this, and Patrick, thank you for coming up, is because I wanted all of you to see my why and what happens when you realize it wasn't about the money. So, thank you for your time. I'm sorry for going a little bit over.
Come from 9 to 1 Wednesday. Don't make excuses. I'll show you the system.